Hi, I'm Yuna, and this is your recap of the Virtual Chrome Dev Summit 2021. In 2020, the Chromium Project started the Compat effort and has been working on making the web platform more interoperable.
One of the most important of these themes comes from feedback that we consistently receive from web developers, both via surveys and individual conversations. And this theme is the importance of cross-browser compatibility. This year, we've added a new initiative to the list, a cross-browser effort called Compat 2021 that's focused on improving compatibility in five key areas of the web, all related, shockingly, to CSS. To measure our progress, the Compat 2021 team was able to use the aforementioned web platform test project to quantify compatibility scores for these areas across the latest development builds of Chrome, Edge, Firefox, and Safari.
Privacy is one of the hot topics this year, and Chrome is championing a couple of efforts here.
It's difficult for developers to meet growing expectations for privacy when so many capabilities rely on third-party cookies and other cross-site tracking mechanisms that weren't designed with privacy in mind. We're working with the web community and industry stakeholders to develop new privacy-preserving technologies that can support a healthy, sustainable ecosystem. Once these new APIs are in place, we'll make sure that developers have time to adopt them so that we can safely phase out support for third-party cookies in Chrome. PrivacySandbox.com explains the vision, goals, and concepts behind this initiative. It also includes a high-level timeline that we're updating every month. User Agent Client Hints, or UACH, launched in Chrome earlier this year and is now ready to scale. It's part of the Privacy Sandbox workstream to reduce covert tracking, such as browser fingerprinting.
Many companies are noticing how the web is continually evolving to be a powerful platform for apps and not just docs.
We're inspired and grateful to see how our partners around the world are building web experiences that enable creativity, expression, communication, entertainment, and so much more. In 2020, Zoom saw a huge influx of people using its web app to chat and connect online. Apple has brought FaceTime links to the web for Android and Windows users, so people can join a FaceTime call from their web browser.
Kapwing is a web-based collaborative video editor designed mainly for casual creatives like game streamers, musicians, YouTube creators, and memers.
After nearly 3 years of an ongoing, strong partnership with Adobe, many flagship apps in the Adobe Creative Cloud Suite are soon coming to the web.
The collaboration between Adobe, Google, and within the standards bodies helped bring the functionality needed for Photoshop into the browser. WebAssembly allowed us to bring large portions of our code base to the web. We are still at the beginning of exploring Photoshop editing features on the web, and we are looking forward to the feedback from the Adobe community.
To help every developer deliver great user experiences, we continue to evolve the Web Vitals program.
We've also worked with some popular JavaScript frameworks, including Next.js and Angular, to deliver the best user experiences possible without sacrificing developer experience. We're calling this initiative Aurora, and thanks to the work we've done to land strong defaults and optimize performance, we're excited to introduce two new metrics we've been experimenting with that we think will improve how user experience is measured on the web. We're still working on both of these metrics, and we'd love to hear your feedback. These articles explain our current thinking in detail, so give them a read and think about how using them can help improve the user experience of your site.
The web is also getting better and better at allowing high-quality, delightful user interfaces. Responsive design is no longer just about making sure an interface looks good on both desktop and mobile devices. Developers now have the tools to really create customized user experiences based on personalized user preferences in a component-driven architecture model. We're calling this the new responsive. We're also partnering with Jeremy Keith of Clear Left to launch Learn Responsive Design on web.dev. This is a free online course with everything you need to know about designing for the new responsive web of today. Dark themes have shown measurable battery life savings over their light theme counterparts on OLED devices. To create a dark theme, we recommend using CSS custom properties and the prefers color scheme media feature, which is supported in all Evergreen browsers. But to make it even easier for your team, Chrome is working on a machine learning aided auto dark algorithm feature. This was your super quick summary of everything we talked about in the Chrome Dev Summit 2021 keynotes. If you want to know more, you can watch the full keynote linked in the description or find articles to all of these topics on web.dev. Thank you so much for joining us.